once I met a fellow who is known as Mr. Gell. If I didn't mention him, he'd be a star as well. If I had my way, I'd like to put him on the pan. All that I can say is that he's just a married man. Mr. Knox was on the job, I shook his hand with ease. Knox was pasted in his hat and Knox were on his knees. As the advertising man, friend Knox was introduced. So you see, the ghost approved that every Knoxy boot. There was Mr. Burns, the man who picks the records out. When it comes to picking, he is there beyond a doubt. If the records turn out good, that don't increase his fame. If they're bad, it's always Mr. Burns who gets the blame. Next comes Mr. Soft, the man who makes the foreign sales. When you speak of traveling, he'll tell you many tales. My advice to Mr. Soft is really not the worst. Speaking of America, why don't he see it first? Then came Mr. Bauer, talk of Oscar Hammerstein. Bauer makes old Oscar look as though he were a shine. What I'm going to tell you now is worse than any crime. Harris says that Bauer has a temper all the time. When I mention Harris, then I mean a friend of mine. Also of each jazz band that you meet along the line. He played me a record that he values more than pearls. You all know the one I mean, made by the Watson girls. Next was Mr. Dorian, who sells the dictaphone. Friend of all stenographers who like to work alone. Wives of all the businessmen declare that he is great. Hubby cannot alibi, he's at the office late. I saw Mr. Goodwin, he's an educated chap. He's a highbrow, I could tell by looking at his map. I must give him credit in these simple little terms. He's the guy that puts it over on the other firms. I saw Mr. Milner, also of the dictaphone. Milner is a name that has a meaning of its own. He can trim you when you buy, you'll all agree to that. But he is one Milner who has never trimmed a hat. Next was Lester Leverett, the marvel of the age. Faster in the office than the boy they call the page. 90 miles a minute is his record, so they say. Don't know where he's going, but he knows he's on his way. Now my little tale's nearly all over, but there's one man who's a rover. We wish the battle was all over, so he'd be here and of yore. Big Vision Whitten, our president, I mean. He's in the Navy, and here he's seldom seen. So, pray for the day when it's all over. He'll come back to us once more.